Hey there, Sun Cutters, Mr. Hanson back with the next video for you guys. Again, COVID style here in my house. Today we're talking about evaluating expressions. So our question is, what is an algebraic expression? Well, it's an expression that contains one or more variables. Okay, and what is a variable? Well, it represents an unknown value. Normally it's letters, like anything A through Z. Okay, but it can be a symbol as well, but it represents an unknown value. Okay. So to evaluate expressions, what are we going to do? We're going to substitute the variable with its given value, which means if they say 5 times A, well, I don't know what A is, but then if someone says, oh, Mr. Hanson, A equals 2, well, then I'm going to replace the A with a 2. That's the substitute, 5 times 2, and then evaluate it using order of operations, which gives me 10, okay? Now, they're not always going to be that easy, okay? But that's the process. We substitute, which means we replace the variable with its actual value given in the problem, and then we just follow order of operations. And again, you can use a calculator to help you. So here we go. Example one, I have 7 times x. So anytime you see this, where a number is right next to a letter, that means multiplication, okay? So this right here means that we are multiplying. Right, super, super important. Anytime you see something next to another thing, a number next to another number, like 7 parentheses 2, that means 7 times 2. If it's x, y, that means x times y. All right, so super important that you guys understand that. No longer use an x to represent multiplication. We can use a dot or we can use closed parentheses. So here we go. 7 times x plus 4 times y. If x has a value of 5 and y has a value of negative 3. So I'm going to rewrite it, substitute first as 7 times, not x anymore, but 5. So I'm going to write it like that, plus 4 times negative 3. So you can see that I substituted the letter x with its value of 5 and the letter y with its value of negative 3. Now I'm just gonna evaluate using order of operations. So I know I'm gonna multiply these two together first, which gives me 35. I'm gonna multiply these two together next, which gives me negative 12. And then the last step is that I need to add them together, right? Remember, you can use your calculator to add and subtract integers if you're not very confident. So Mr. Hanson, I don't feel confident, that's okay. I'm going to pull up my calculator here and I'm going to type in 35 plus, remember the negative sign is below the 3, and then I enter 12, I get the value of positive 23. So 23 is the value of that expression, all right? Questions on that? Hopefully not. If you got questions, make sure that you always email one of your teachers, myself or Ms. Sherrard. We're more than happy to help you out. All right, example two. Now we're getting a little more complex. So this says 9 times a squared, all right? 9 times a squared minus 2 times b squared. Remember, a times 9, but a is first squared, which means exponents go first. This, again, since 9 and a are next to each other, means multiplication, okay? Now it tells us what the value of A is, it's 4 and B is 7. So I'm going to rewrite it first by substituting. All right, so here we go. Clear my calculator over here. If it works, maybe it doesn't, I'm just gonna swipe it. All right, so here we go. I'm going to rewrite this as 9 parentheses 4 squared, okay, minus 2 parentheses, and the value of b was 7, and that is also squared. Okay, now I'm going to evaluate my exponents. So I'm going to rewrite this again as 9 times 4 times 4 is 16, minus 2 times 7, which is 49, because that's what squared is, it's multiplied by itself. All right. Again, I could have used my calculator and typed in 4 to the second power, which is 16, 7 to the second power, which is 49. Now I need to multiply 9 by 16 and 2 by 49. Now again, you don't feel confident, no shame in pulling out that calculator, okay? So I have 9 times 16, enter, 144. Minus 2 times 49 gives us 98. So now I need to subtract those two to get my value. 144 take away 98. And this expression has a value of 46. All right, there we go. Next example, example number 3. I have 4 times m squared plus 5 times m. And it says if m equals negative 2. So always the first step, replace the letter with its numerical value. So I'm going to rewrite this as 4 parentheses negative 2 squared plus 5 times negative 2. All right, because m and the value of negative 2. Now, remember, when you type this on your calculator, when you're typing a negative number to the second power, to any power for that matter, you need to use parentheses. Parentheses are right above the 8 and 9 on your calculator. I'm going to type in negative 2, close it off, then hit my square button, then enter. It's going to become now a positive 4. So I have 4 times 4 plus 5 times negative 2 gives me negative 10 because it stays negative. I need to multiply 4 by 4 first, which gives me 16. Now I can add that to negative 10. Now I'm keeping the parentheses around negative 10, so I remember that that's a negative 10. So it's not plus minus 10, because that doesn't make sense. All right, so now I can type on my calculator, 16 plus negative 10, enter. Gives me the value of positive 6. And there we go. Example 4. Now, here's the first time you see this. Remember, this means the letter C is being multiplied by the letter D. So when I replace it with the values, I'm going to write it as a multiplication problem. So I have parentheses 8C minus D divided by CD, which means C times D. And remember, this means 8 times C. All right, now it gives me the values of C, which is 2, and D, which is, calculator's in the way there, negative 4, okay? All right, here we go. Substitute the values. So I have parentheses 8 times the value of C, which we said was 2, minus the value of D, which we know is now negative 4. So remember, if I have a negative, I need to write as a negative. Now that's being divided by 2 times negative 4 because CD means multiplication. So now I have parentheses here. I have 8 times 2 minus a negative 4. So I need to evaluate inside here. Multiply first, which is 16 minus negative 4. So I still have parentheses divided by 2 times negative 4. Now remember, we talked about this. We've talked about this several times. But when we see this, we don't speak in the double negatives. I wouldn't say don't not, because it's do not not, that doesn't make sense. So I can't subtract a negative, so that becomes just a positive. And if I even type it on my calculator over here, okay, if it will let me, I got 16, oh, my calculator is stuck, there we go, 16 minus negative 4 gives me actually positive 20 because 16 plus 4 is 20. All right, so I go back to my problem here. I have 16 plus 4, I'll switch colors to go to blue, that's 20. 2 times negative 4, okay, is not going to be evaluated yet, all right? Because if you notice, we have dividing. We divide and multiply left to right. Because if I were to multiply those, 20 divided by 8 doesn't work out very nice, all right? So don't multiply until the very end, especially if division is before it, okay? So I'm actually going to divide 20 by 2 first, which gives me 10 times negative 4. 10 and 4 make 40, and since there's one negative, integer rules tells me it's going to stay as negative 40. All right, there we have it. All right, example 5. I have parentheses a times b, and that's all going to be squared, minus 4 times b to the third power plus 1. A is 3 and b is 2. So here we go. Let's rewrite it. Use a little bigger dot here. Parentheses. A we said was 2, or excuse me, 3. B was 2. So I'm going to rewrite this as 3 times 2. I can use the dot if I want to. And that's squared minus 4 times b is 2 to the third power plus 1. All right? A lot going on here. I need to multiply 3 by 2 first. 3 times 2 is 6. So I rewrite this as 6 squared minus 4 times 2 to the third plus 1. 6 squared is 36. 2 to the third power is 8. So I have 4 times 8. And then adding 1. Now I need to multiply 4 by 8. So I have 36 minus 4 times 8, which I know is 32, plus 1. So now I'm going to subtract 36 by 32, which gives me 4. Add the 1. 4 plus 1 gives me its value of 5. All right, we can evaluate expressions with absolute value, with radical signs. It doesn't matter. They can be in fraction form, decimal form. It doesn't matter, okay? So I have 2 times the absolute value of r minus 3 times r times s. R is negative 5, s is positive 4. So here we go. Let's rewrite this. 2, I'm going to use the dot for multiplication, times the absolute value of r, which again was negative 5, minus 3 times negative 5 times the value of s, which is 4. So I need to evaluate the absolute value first because that's a grouping symbol, okay? So now I rewrite this as 2 times absolute value of 5, which is positive 5, minus 3 times negative 5 times 4. All right? All multiplication needs to be done before we subtract in the middle. So 2 times 5 is 10. Now, 3 times negative 5 is negative 15, and I need to multiply that by 4. So I have minus, and that's going to give me negative 60. Right? Big number. So now remember, talked about this several times, I'll go back to red. I cannot minus a negative because that does not work. So I'm actually going to rewrite it as addition. 10 plus 60 is 70. And we are done. Okay, I'm going to skip example 7 and let you guys try that out on your own, because I want to get to example 8. Because if you notice on example 8, like I said, we have fractions. We can solve expressions with fractions because we know how to multiply, add, subtract, and divide fractions. So I have 2 thirds times x squared minus 5 times x plus 8, and x is going to have a value of 6. So watch as I rewrite this. 2 thirds times 6 squared minus 5 times 6 plus 8. All right? Evaluate exponents first. 6 times itself, or 6 squared on the calculator here, is 36. So I have 2 thirds times 36 minus 5 times 6 plus 8. Now I can multiply 2 thirds by 36, and I can multiply 5 by 6 at the same time because I don't have any division to worry about, okay? So remember, on your calculator, my fraction key is right here, n over d. So I'm going to do 2 thirds times 36 as a whole number. Gives me 24. Minus 5 times 6 is 30. Plus 8. Now this, I can actually type it all on my calculator. Watch. I can do 24 minus 30 plus 8. And it will give me the correct value. Okay? Does that make sense? Because if I did it separately, 24 minus 30 is negative 6 plus 8. Is still 2. So I have a value of 2. Okay, I'm going to do a couple more examples. Again, I'm going to skip example 9 because that one we've done several times already, You guys can do that on your own. Okay, I'm gonna actually jump to example 10 because that has a radical sign. So I have the square root of 3 times p minus q minus p squared plus p times q. P is 10 and q is 14. Holy smokes, there's a lot going on here. So watch as I rewrite this. The square root of 3 times p, which is 10, minus 14. That's all under the radical sign. Minus p, which is 10 squared, plus 10 times 14. Holy cow. All right, since I have multiple things going on underneath the radical sign, it's like grouping. I have to evaluate those first. I can't take the square root of 3, square root of 10, and square root of 14, and then try to multiply and subtract them. It just won't work. I'm going to get a decimal that's longer than my arms. Okay? So, I'm going to do 3 times 10, which is 30. Whoops, screen switched there. So I have the square root of 30, take away 14, which I'm going to evaluate. 30 minus 14 is 16. That looks so much better. Now I can take the square root of 16. And I have minus 10, which is squared, plus 10 times 14. Okay? So again, much easier to work with. I can evaluate my radical sign and exponent at the same time because it goes around with the second rule, exponents and radicals. So the square root of 16 is 4. Again, second x squared, type in 16, enter, there's 4. Minus 10 times itself is 100. Plus, I'm going to actually evaluate multiplication next because I just have adding and subtracting left. So 10 times 14 is 140. Now, again, I can type this all on my calculator one time. 4 minus 100 plus 140. I get a positive value of 44. Okay? Last example we'll do together is example 11. Again, you can do order of operations in fractional form, so we can evaluate expressions algebraically in fractional form. So I have 2 times A times B all over 7B, which is 7 times B, minus A squared times B. A is 3, B is 12. So again, I substitute and rewrite 2 times. We said A was 3. Times B, which we said was 12, all over 7 times 12 minus 3 to the second power times 12. So there's my entire fraction. All right, evaluate the top, evaluate the bottom, then divide it together, all together at the end. 2 times 3 times 12, I can do all together on my calculator, which gives me 72 on the top. Over. I need to evaluate the exponent, which is 3 squared, which is 9. I can do multiplication, 7 times 12. That's 84. Minus 9 times 12. So 9 times 12 on my calculator is 108. So I have 84 minus 108. 84 take away 108. That gives me negative 24 on the bottom. Right, so there's my simplified expression. Now I can try to divide this. 72 divided by negative 24 gives me my value of negative 3. All right. Example 12 is very similar, so is example 13, 14. Okay, we'll actually do one more together because I want to do another fraction one here. Example 15, 3/4 times C minus 1/6 times D. C is also a fraction, 2/9, and D is negative 4. Wait, you're telling me that an unknown value can be a decimal or a fraction? Absolutely it can. So I'm going to rewrite this as 3/4 times C, which is 2/9 now, minus 1/6 times the value of D, which is negative 4. Remember to multiply fractions on your calculator. Type in your fraction key, 3/4 times, make sure you arrow over, 2/9. That gives me 1/6. I can multiply this expression on my calculator, 1/6. So I do 1/6 times -4. That gives me -2/3. I can do subtraction on my calculator. So watch, I'm gonna do 1/6 minus -2/3. Enter. Gives me a positive value of 5/6, because when you subtract a negative, it becomes positive. All right? There you have it. There's a few examples that you can try on your own. Okay? So make sure you guys do these examples on your own, like example 7, 9, 12, 13, 14, and 16. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to do on your own. We did about 12 together. So that's it for evaluating algebraic expressions. Replace the value in for the letter. Use order of operations to solve it. Use your calculators. We'll see you next time.